It's well known that Slytherin has constantly been associated with evil witches and wizards, most of which became Death Eaters, but this fact has been taken seriously in every case.
Slytherin!
That's not a witch or wizard who went bad who wasn't in Slytherin.
In today's video, I'll be defending the Slytherin house by showing you 4 evil wizards who weren't in Slytherin, and also 4 Slytherin wizards who choose to be good. So let's get started. Number 4, evil wizard not in Slytherin, Gilderoy Lockhart. Although he wasn't a complete dark wizard, Gilderoy had some evil thoughts and plans, convincing everyone that he's a stand-up guy worth all the praise in the world. However, his true villainy in pursuit of never-ending glory eventually comes to light, unraveling his entire life. The Sorting Hat was unable to decide between Ravenclaw or Slytherin, eventually stuck him in Ravenclaw. Lockhart studied memory spells extensively, and at some point began using them to steal other people's stories. He created a heroic personality that amazed everyone he met, and went to great lengths to preserve it. He even tries to claim the glory attributed to Ron and Harry after they discovered the Chamber of Secrets. Thankfully for the two, the memory charm he attempted to cast backfires. He loses all his memories as a result, and takes up permanent residence in St. Mungo's Hospital for magical maladies and injuries. At the end of the day, while he isn't Voldemort's levels of evil, Gilderoy Lockhart's love of the spotlight pushes him to do evil things for even the smallest bit of praise. He feels no shame for his actions, despite ruining the lives of many innocent people. He eventually received what he deserved, thankfully. Slytherin witch not evil, Andromeda Black. Even though she didn't make many appearances in the books, it's known that Sirius once referred to her as his favorite cousin. She's the mother of Nymphadora Tonks and the sister of both Bellatrix and Narcissa. She's a complete good witch and definitely stood out from her fellow Slytherin housemates. Andromeda married a muggle-born named Tim Tonks, which is what earned her a burn mark on the Black family tree as seen in the Order of Phoenix. Plus, she was a member of the Order of Phoenix during Voldemort's first attempt of rising to power and wasn't upset that her daughter married a werewolf like Lupin. She's definitely a character that we would have loved to have seen more of. Number 3, evil wizard not in Slytherin, Professor Quirrell. When Quirrell traveled the world, he set out to find whatever remained of Voldemort. When Voldemort realized the young man had a position at Hogwarts, he immediately took possession of Quirrell, who was incapable of resisting. Quirrell spent the last year of his life attempting to procure the Philosopher's Stone for Voldemort, so he can be brought back to life. Students at Hogwarts diverted suspicion away from his plans, as Quirrell was a foolish professor. He manipulated everyone and convinced the whole school that he was a normal, kind professor. Quirrell became a dark wizard that would do anything to obtain the power Voldemort wants, so he can be taken seriously for the first time. He even tried to kill Harry twice in the process, but in the second attempt, he was unfortunately defeated. Thus, Voldemort left his body to die, proving his master didn't care about nothing but his own soul. Slytherin wizard not evil, Regulus Black. Regulus Black was the youngest brother of Sirius. He was a member of the noble House of Black, an old wizarding family. Regulus was admired by his parents for his loyalty towards his family and upholding their traditions. Regulus became a Death Eater in his youth and received his Dark Mark around the age of 16. But Regulus had begun to have doubts about serving as a Death Eater. One day, Voldemort used Creature to test the defenses around his Locket Horcrux, leaving him to die afterwards. Creature was able to escape using House Elf magic and told Regulus of what had happened. Regulus created a duplicate of the Locket. He then ordered Creature to take him to where the real locket was hidden. Regulus drank the potion himself, and when he tried to get water from the lake, he was dragged to his death by the Enfery. Creature obeyed his master's final order and switched the locket before escaping. Regulus Black died an expected hero. Sirius would have been so proud of his brave brother in taking a great risk for no personal reward. His is one of the most noblest sacrifices in the entire series. Number 2, evil wizard not in Slytherin, Peter Pettigrew. Peter Pettigrew may be the most evil character of the whole entire series. He was already spying on the Order of Phoenix for Voldemort and immediately informed his master of the whereabouts of the Potters. A coward by nature, Peter betrayed his friends, arranged for Lily and James' death, cost Sirius his freedom, lived life as a rat for 12 years, cost Sirius his freedom again, and helped Voldemort rise again. If it wasn't for Peter, Voldemort would have remained a shade for the rest of his days, sparing the Wizarding War a second war. Although Peter is not the Dark Lord himself, he drives home the point that evil would be nothing without its supporters. Slytherin Wizard Not Evil, Horace Slughorn. Slughorn is quite possibly one of the most complex yet important characters in the Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince. A former head of Slytherin House and one of the greatest potion masters to have ever taught at Hogwarts, Slughorn was known for being a social professor. He always sought to be around the best of the best and even established the Slug Club, which was full of students he thought to be exceptional. His actions may not have always been pure of heart, but he proved to be a fantastic professor. Of course, he's the reason why Voldemort was able to create Horcruxes and rise to power. However, he began to redeem himself by saving students from being bullied by the Carrow siblings. He also took part in the Battle of Hogwarts, confronting Voldemort alongside Professor McGonagall and Kingsley. He aimed to redeem himself by standing up to the one person who manipulated him for selfish needs. Number 1. Evil Wizard Not in Slytherin, Barty Crouch Jr. He was a Ravenclaw, if none of you ever knew. Barty Crouch Jr. was a nasty piece of work, taking the Dark Mark at an early age and showing support for Lord Voldemort. His father Barty Sr. sent him to Azkaban for torturing the Aurors Frank and Alice Longbottom, but even then, a mother's love shone through. She persuaded her husband to allow her to switch places with her son in prison using Polyjuice Potion. Big mistake. Although Barty Sr. kept eyes on Jr. for a while with an Imperius Curse and Invisibility Cloak, he broke free at the Quidditch World Cup in Goblet of Fire and began causing trouble on behalf of Voldemort once again. He assumed the appearance of Alistair Moody, sent an underage Harry into the Tribes of Tournament and caused the death of Cedric Diggory, and also worked on the return of the darkest wizard of all time. So Barty Crouch Jr. is another reason why being a dark wizard has nothing to do with being in Slytherin. And finally, Slytherin wizard who's definitely not evil, Severus Snape. Snape started off as the prime example of evil wizard that would fit perfectly within the Slytherin house. The love he had for someone special is what caused both his fall into Voldemort's forces and his reason to defect from them. He may be one of the most controversial characters in the series because of this, but he still managed to redeem himself. Although he didn't show it, he did care about Harry, even though it could be argued that he was just out of love for Lily. Regardless, he still protected him and made sure to keep his cover as a servant of Voldemort. He agreed to Dumbledore's demand to kill him in order to save him from a painful death and to prevent Draco from taking a life. Even after becoming headmaster, he still tried to protect his students as much as possible. In the end, he sacrificed himself so that Harry could learn the truth about the night his parents died and what Dumbledore had been planning. What do you guys think of Slytherin House? That was all for today. Make sure to like this video and subscribe to the channel, it would be very much appreciated. Until next time, I'll see you guys soon.